First, breaking news in the first 10 minutes. Strong thunderstorm winds blew over at least two semi-trucks out on the I-10 west of the valley.
At least one person has been killed. Let's take a look at the map. The accident is blocking lanes right now near Tonopah. Both east and westbound lanes are affected. Our reporter Kim Powell just got on scene. She is joining us now live with the developing details. Kim?
Hey guys, we just got here about 5 minutes ago, so we're still trying to get a lay of the land here, but I can tell you that we're on the shoulder of the westbound lanes of I-10, and right behind me, you can barely see it. I know it's so dark out here, but right there off in the bushes right there is one of the semis that has turned over. Just past that one is another semi that turned over. Again, this is the westbound lanes, and from what we can tell, it seems like most of this is happening in the eastbound lanes. We still haven't seen that just yet. This seems to be spanning over a couple of miles out here off of I-10. This is just west of Tonopah. So that we're hearing that this is all because of strong winds that were in the area. We are told that this was about, according to the National Weather Service, it estimates about 40 to 50 mile per hour winds out here. This happened again in the eastbound lanes around 7:30, and the westbound lanes we're told were affected because of debris in the area as well as other collisions. So I think that's what we're seeing here, are these other collisions that they're talking about. So I'm not sure the total number of semi trucks that have turned over because of those winds. We're still working to figure that out here. ADOT is telling us to expect delays in this area for the foreseeable future. They say that the eastbound lanes are closed and the left westbound lane is closed at mile marker 83. And again, we're not quite there yet, so we haven't even seen that part yet. There is no estimated amount of time when traffic will resume as normal. DPS says an investigation like this could take several hours because it does involve one fatality. We are hearing that at least one person has died. We're not sure on any other injuries at this point, but they say with multiple crashes like this, overturned semis, it is going to take them a while. So I think we're going to start heading up the road a little bit to see what we can see on the eastbound side and what else is affecting the westbound lane. So for now, I'll send it back to you guys.
Boy, big mess out there. We haven't even seen the entire scope. Kim Powell, thank you so much.